Here are just a handful of the high crimes and misdemeanors committed by Barack Hussein Obama. He lied to the American people when he said we could keep our private insurance, knowing full well that his legislation would inevitably drive private insurers out of business. Barack Hussein Obama is running up our debt at an alarming rate. In just 9 months since Obama assumed office, our national debt has gone up by over $1 trillion. To put that figure in perspective, it took George W. Bush 8 years to add $4.8 trillion to the national debt. And to add insult to injury, we're printing money like it's going out of style. The effect will be hyperinflation, a crippling of our economy, and quite possibly personal hardship on a scale that has not been experienced since the Great Depression. Barack Hussein Obama has appointed countless czars to oversee everything, from the closing of Guantanamo to the food we eat. These czars don't have to be approved by the Senate. The czars have unprecedented power and report only to Obama. And finally, Obama has consistently refused to approve the release of his actual birth certificate, college transcripts, and his medical records. It's almost as if Obama is intentionally trying to destroy the country. Barack Hussein Obama has said that America is not a Christian nation on countless occasions, despite surveys that a whopping majority say the contrary. In his book, The Audacity of Hope, he wrote of Muslims and Arabic immigrants, "I will stand with them should the political wind shift in an ugly direction." When he spoke at Georgetown University, a Catholic institution, the White House insisted that the name of Jesus be covered. Georgetown complied. In 2006, he said, "Whatever we once were, we are no longer a Christian nation." He went to Egypt and said, "You might say that America is a Muslim nation." Why go to such lengths to deny the Christian heritage of the United States? Surely Barack Hussein Obama knows that our personal liberties flow directly from our Christian heritage, that there is no surer way to destroy our republic than to deny that heritage. President Thomas Jefferson said, "God who gave us life gave us liberty. Can the liberties of a nation be secure when we have removed a conviction that these liberties are the gift of God?" And President Andrew Jackson called the Bible the rock upon which our republic rests. Patrick Henry said, "It is when a people forget God that tyrants forge their chains." It's enough to make one wonder, does Barack Hussein Obama realize that every stab he takes at the Christian heritage of this great nation is a blow to the very foundation of our nation, a blow to freedom, our personal liberty? Does he simply hate Christianity? Does he hate the United States, or both? Barack Hussein Obama simply hasn't denied the Christian heritage of this nation. He has used his presidency to badmouth America itself at every turn. He said America has been arrogant, thus giving our enemies and our allies every reason to believe that we are less resolved to defend ourselves and hence more vulnerable to attack. Following his inauguration, he ordered Gitmo closed within a year, despite the fact that it was, and is, the best possible facility for detaining terrorists. His first presidential phone call was to Mahmoud Abbas, a leader of the Fatah party in the Palestine territory. According to press reports, he told Abbas, "This is my first phone call to a foreign leader, and I'm making it only hours after I took office." His first one-on-one TV interview was not with NBC or ABC, but with Al Arabiya, where he said, "My job to the Muslim world is to communicate that Americans are not your enemy. We sometimes make mistakes. We have not been perfect." He immediately issued an executive order halting military commissions, which resulted in charges being dropped against Abd al-Rahim al-Nashiri, the animal accused of planning numerous terrorist attacks against Americans, including the USS Cole bombing in which 17 US sailors died. While treating the Queen of England with casual familiarity, he obsequiously bowed from the waist to King Abdullah of Saudi Arabia, leader of a Muslim nation that won't permit Christian worship within its borders under penalty of death. Barack Hussein Obama's words and actions clearly rise well beyond the level of bad behavior, and our founding fathers left us a remedy for presidents guilty of bad behavior. If you would like to add your name to the articles of impeachment that have been drawn up against Barack Hussein Obama, please click on the link to the right in the video description and do what you can to help support this cause.